I have 7 Lightroom tricks to show you today that I'm sure most photographers don't know. These aren't the common tricks you see online. They're new and designed to help you create better edits with simple tools, saving you time in the process. Be sure to stick around for the bonus tip at the end, where I'll share critical information about a very popular Lightroom slider you should avoid. One of my all-time favorite Lightroom techniques helps create subject separation. Using this technique will help a subject pop from the background and create depth. To do this, create a subject selection and add texture, clarity, warmth, and contrast. Duplicate and invert the subject selection to select the background. Then decrease texture and clarity, cool down the white balance. Apply negative dehaze and negative contrast. Doing this will create different effects that offset nicely against each other, making the subject pop. Make sure the subject selection is refined for the best results. Consider this technique the next time you want to create a subject mask. Create the subject mask, then feather it by subtracting multiple brush strokes from it, using the soft character of the outside of a large brush. Faintly painting away the edges of the subject mask allows your effect to faintly fade from the center to the outside of the mask, eliminating any unnatural results. Make sure the feather of the brush is set to 100. I save a ton of time when I first start editing a photo by applying what I call an initialization preset. This preset automatically sets the camera profile to what I want, sets all sliders to 0, and more importantly, applies settings I use on every photo, such as chromatic aberration correction and color noise reduction. It also removes any default sharpening if Lightroom automatically applies it. The initialization preset establishes the starting point for every edit I do. To create an initialization preset, load up a photograph, click reset at the bottom to ensure all sliders are at 0, add the effects you want to include, and then create the preset by clicking the plus button and naming your preset. Simply click on this preset the next time you edit a photo to apply the required starting point. Avoid using the vignette tool in the effects panel. While it can create a decent vignette, it lacks sufficient customization options. Instead, use a radial gradient. This tool can achieve precisely what the vignette tool does, but with a significantly higher level of customization. You gain access to the entire range of develop options, along with the ability to customize the shape of the vignette and its position. Additionally, you have the option to remove the vignette from specific areas. In this example, I'm applying a vignette around my subject. I want the vignette to be dark to help highlight the subject. I also want to avoid darkening the bright area of the sky in the corner, so I'm using a linear gradient to remove the vignette from that region. By creatively utilizing the develop options and masks, you can create amazing vignettes. Dodging and burning is a technique that incorporates selective brightening and darkening. I'm producing a video that goes into greater depth on this topic soon, so do subscribe if you want to see that video. I use a brush to perform all of my dodging and burning, together with a subject selection. To start, I create a subject selection mask and then duplicate it. I rename the masks as subject dodge and the other subject burn. Select the dodge mask and increase the exposure. Intersect the mask with the brush and set the brush feather to 100, the flow to 50, and density to 100, and uncheck auto mask. Paint on the areas you want to be brightened. Because of the lower flow of the brush, multiple brush strokes will be needed to build up the effect. To burn or darken parts of the photo, choose the burn mask, decrease the exposure, and intersect with a brush mask using the same brush settings as before. Paint on the areas you want to darken. Using dodging and burning can help shape light on your subject, creating beautiful depth. Use other effects like a cooler white balance for dark areas or a warmer white balance for bright areas. Further enhance the depth of your photograph by darkening the immediate foreground with a simple linear gradient with negative exposure and negative dehaze. This will help draw the viewer's eye into the scene a lot easier. If you're having difficulty setting the white balance, adjust your vibrance and saturation to 100. This action will intensify all the colors in your photo, thereby amplifying the overall temperature of the image and facilitating easier white balance adjustments. By toggling the white balance slider back and forth, you can fine-tune the color relationships and achieve the desired color separation. Apply the same method to adjust the tint slider. Remember to reset the saturation and vibrance sliders to 0 afterwards and take a brief break from the computer, as the saturated colors may momentarily distort your vision. A versatile trick for drawing out details from your shadows and highlights is to avoid using a certain Lightroom slider. as it has the potential to destroy the tonality of your photograph. Discover which slider it is and what you should use instead in this video here.